I said to the Lord, You are my God, hear the voice of my supplications, O Lord. O God the Lord, the strength of my salvation, you have covered my head in the day of battle. Do not grant, O Lord, the desires of the wicked, do not further his wicked scheme, lest they be exalted. Selah. Psalm 141, 6-8. Father, you are my God, you are the only God. There really is no other. There is no other in heaven or earth that we can turn to. You are the hope of our salvation in all ways. You are my protection from the enemy at all times. You are our covering in and out of battles. I ask you holy blessing as I meditate on David's words this morning. There was nothing that he did not trust you with. I come in the mighty name of your Son, Jesus Christ, to pray and seek strength for today. Amen. Lord, supplication means to earnestly and humbly seek the help of another or of you here. David begs you to hear his cries to you. David knows that without you he is nothing and can overcome nothing. He understands his strength and victory has always been, in every battle, your covering. When a youth, the bear, the lion, and Goliath. But as a man his strength, his protection is still only you. By your grace and mercy, you have delivered him from every enemy he has faced and even the spear of Saul. He knows your shield is over him. Now he is facing another enemy and he once more seeks your protection, your loving covering over him. I love David. He calls out to you to hear him once more and that once more you cover him not only in godly protection but his head, his thoughts too, even his imagination, or anticipations of things. In our heads is the greatest battles, we are first defeated or victorious there. But I know, and so did David, that you could work through your spirit in us there. David had asked you to never take your spirit from him. He had seen firsthand what happened to Saul when you did. Saul's last days were not full of peace or success, sadly, because of his will to please others instead of following your words to him, his lack of obedience. David, as I do, wants to do right and to seek your covering in every area of his life, his mind, his heart, his will, his physical battles with enemies as well, but our inward spirits especially. You are our peace, our goodness is all wrapped up in your spirit indwelling our hearts and minds. Lord, I do not know how people can get by these days when you are not the God of their lives. In what do they hope? David says, do not let the wicked be victorious, please do not let them gloat or even taste any victory over good. Don't let their desires come to fruition. But he came to you for your intervention and suppression of their evil schemes. Father, I too come this morning for the same petition. Lord, they have legalized late-term, full-term abortion. There is rampant immoral depravity all around and what was once seen as evil is now good and rightful. Father, I come in the name of your Son, Jesus, to ask that you overcome evil that is happening. I ask that the righteous are not punished with the ungodly. That you make a distinction between the righteous and the unrighteous. I know there are still good there in government or that you will redeem before it is too late. I come to pray for their protection and deliverance. And also to pray for the protection of our president and vice president and their families. Lord, Satan has come only to rob, kill, and destroy all you created for good. I know one day before too much longer you will have your day of justice and vengeance on all evil, but until then we, who are called by your name, need your covering. I call out to you to please hear the cries of your children. Lord, the need is the same in my heart. I need your covering over my head. I need your protection. I want my heart and my mind protected from evil, Lord. Holy Spirit, I ask you to set a guard over me and to lead me in the way of the Lord. I want to live my last days right and in your power and strength. Help me, I pray. I can do nothing good or of worth in your kingdom without your covering. Have mercy over me and lead me in paths of righteousness for your holy name's sake. I am so lost without your mercy and covering. I close my morning prayer in the holy name of my Lord Jesus Christ, praise you, Amen.